spaces. So in previous two sessions, we discussed about what do we mean by development. Okay, in development, what we are going to do is we are going to unfold the surfaces of the solid. Okay, so this development will be used in sheet metal working processes, and for mechanical engineers it is very useful and it is very important. Okay, so the concept that you are going to learn in development of surfaces is useful in basic workshop lab. So all those things I told you in the previous session. So in development, we are going to consider some of the regular solids and we are going to develop them. In order to understand the concepts or fundamentals of development, we are going to consider some of the solids. Okay, in this figure you are having 3D models of the of various solids. Now you have to identify which are the solids, what do we call this, this and this. Okay, it is in a, it is not arranged properly. Okay, so can you name the solid? What is this solid? First one, what is the name of the solid? Hey, what is the name of the solid? So you have to answer.
Cone.
Cone. Second one, this solid. What is the name of this
square
solid?
Pyramid.
Square pyramid. Okay. Next, what is the name of the solid?
Cylinder.
Cylinder. This is
prism.
Triangular prism. Okay, so this is the cone, this is the square pyramid, this is the cylinder, and this is the triangular prism. Okay, so in today's class I am going to consider the cylinder. Okay, and in previous class we considered prism and we have discussed about its development. Okay, so again, for prism and cylinder we are going to use parallel line method. Okay, in previous class, so I have solved a problem related to a prism. Okay, in this class again I am going to make use of parallel line method to solve a problem related to cylinder. Okay, before going to the actual problem, first we should be able to understand how we can define the details of a cylinder. Okay, this is the cylinder. And so it will be having axis, base and top end surface. Okay, and it will be having generators. Okay, so if you look from this, if you look at the solid from top, okay, and if you draw a top view of this cylinder, how does it look like? Ek answer. So from top, if you look at this cylinder, which is kept in vertical orientation, how does it look like?
Circle.
A circle. Okay, so in the top view it looks like a circle. So whereas it is going to represent two faces, so top end face is visible whereas bottom end face is invisible. Okay, so top view will be projected on the horizontal plane. So that is this one. It is also known as top plane. Okay, so top view will be represented on the horizontal plane, or it will be projected on the horizontal plane. Okay, this is the front view, that is vertical plane, VP. From front, okay, so you are looking from this direction. This is the front direction. Okay, so you are looking from this direction. So now how does it look like? Okay, so from front, if you look at the cylinder, how does it appear? From top it appears like a circle. From front, how does it look like?
Rectangle.
Really? So it will look like a rectangle. Okay, so in front view it look like a rectangle, and in top it look like a circle. Okay, and again cylinder will be having a axis, that is the imaginary line passing through center of end faces. So this is the top end face and this is the bottom end face. An imaginary line passing through the centers of these two end faces is called as the axis. Okay, axis of the cylinder. So next, so height of the cylinder, this is the height of the cylinder. Okay, next it will be having a diameter. Diameter of the cylinder means that is the diameter of the end surfaces. So this is top end surface, it will be having a diameter, and bottom end surface is also will be having the same diameter. Okay, and again, so are you able to see any visible edges on the sides? So in case of prism, you are able to see the lateral edges. In case of cylinder, are you able to see any of the lateral edge? So lateral edge anta enadru idya? Okay, you cannot see any lateral edge in case of a cylinder. Okay, so that's why we consider only the generators. Okay, so this is one generator, and this is on the other side there is another generator. Okay, so in this figure you can see, so in front view, if you look from this direction, this is the direction of the observer. Okay, from front, so it will look like a rectangle. From top it will look like a circle. This is the top view of the cylinder, and this is the front view of the cylinder. Front view will appear on VP, that is vertical plane. Top view will appear on HP. Okay, and this cylinder is called as solids of revolution. Okay, if you revolve a rectangle for 360 degree by considering an axis as a reference, okay, and if you revolve a rectangle for 360 degree, you are going to get the cylinder. That's why it is called as solids of revolution. Cylinder is one of the solid of revolution. Okay, so in case of development, we are not in most of the cases we are not going to develop the complete solid. Instead of developing a complete solid, what we are going to do is we will pass a cutting plane, and by passing cutting plane we will cut the solid, and we'll remove the top above portion, and we are going to develop the remaining portion, that is the bottom portion which is left behind. So after cutting the top portion, okay, so in development we are not going to develop the complete solid, we are going to pass a cutting plane such that this cutting plane is perpendicular to vertical plane, and it may be inclined to HP, or it may be inclined to axis of the solid. Okay, and we are going to develop only the remaining portion of the solid, that means this one. Okay, so here the detail in blue which represents a cutting plane. Okay, so these are the illustrations where you can visualize how cutting plane will pass through a solid. Okay, so this is a case where cutting plane is perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP. Okay, and here, so passing it at certain height. So this is a case where cutting plane is perpendicular to VP and inclined to HP. Okay, in this illustration, cutting plane is parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. Okay, so in different ways you can pass a cutting plane, that means you can cut the solid in different ways. Okay, so this is the procedure followed in developing cylinder. Okay, if this is the cylinder, it will be having a height of the cylinder, and it will be having diameter, that is the diameter of the end faces. Okay, so as we know, development means we are unfolding the surfaces, we are unfolding the surface of the cylinder. Okay, you can consider any point from where you can start unfolding it. Okay, when you unfold, So this width will be equal to the circumference of the circle. Okay. So this width will be equal to this dimension. Okay, if you consider the complete circle, and if you unfold the circle into a line, okay, the length of that line, if you unfold a circle into a straight line, okay, that length of the straight line will be equal to width of the cylinder. Okay, that is given by pi d. So before going for development, so you have to find the value of this pi d. You have to draw a horizontal line like this, which the length of that line should be equal to pi d. D is the diameter, so pi you can consider it as 3.14. Okay, and this vertical line length will be equal to height of the cylinder. Okay, so this is how we are going to develop a cylinder in parallel line method. Okay, so next, so consider the actual problem. Okay, so this is the problem: a vertical cylinder. That means cylinder is kept in vertical orientation like this. Okay, vertical cylinder of 60 mm diameter. So that means diameter of the end surfaces, this diameter is 60. At the bottom also it will be having 60 mm diameter. Okay, and 80 mm height, that means height is 80 mm, this height. Okay, so this is 80 mm, or you can consider from center of the base to center of the top end face. If you draw a vertical line, the length of that line will be equal to 80 mm. Okay, so here there is a cylinder which is kept in vertical orientation, and it is having a diameter of 60 mm, and it is having a height of 80 mm. Okay, it is cut by a section plane. So this is the section plane. It is cut by a section plane perpendicular to VP. Okay, perpendicular to VP, vertical plane. So the screen itself is vertical. Okay, if you are using a desktop or laptop, okay, if you kept your screen vertical, that itself is the vertical plane. Okay, so this cutting plane is perpendicular to that vertical plane. Okay, and it is inclined at 45 degree to the axis. Axis will be a line like this, vertical line. Okay, so I am drawing the axis. Okay, so this is the axis. So this cutting plane is making an angle of 45 degree. Okay, so this angle is 45. Okay, so it is cut by a section plane perpendicular to VP. That means perpendicular to this. Okay, and 45 degree to the axis. This is the axis of the cylinder, and this cutting plane is making an inclination 45 degree. Okay, so it has to pass through the top end of one of the extreme generators. Okay, in case of cylinder, there are no visible lateral edges. You cannot see a visible lateral edge in case of a cylinder. Okay, so we are going to consider only the generators. So this is one end generator, and this is another generator. So here this cutting plane has to pass such that, so this end should be at this location here. It should be lifted such that it will go to this position. Okay, so 45 degree to the axis, so it has to pass through the top end of one of the extreme generators in the front view. So this is top end of one of the generator, this is top view of another generator. You can either consider the top of end generator at left or right. Okay, I will consider on the right hand side, that means here. Okay, so now from front, this cutting plane will be represented with a line like this. Okay, so this is the representation of a cutting plane. And you are going to develop the remaining portion below the cutting plane. So that means whatever there below. So this you are going to develop, you are going to unfold it. Okay. So a vertical cylinder of 60 mm. A vertical cylinder of 60 mm diameter. Okay, and 80 mm height is cut by a section plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 45 degree like this, 45 degree to the axis. This is the axis of the cylinder, to the axis, so as to pass through the top end of one of the extreme generators. So this is one generator, this line, vertical line is generator. This is another generator. Top end means either this point or this. You can choose either this one or this one. Okay, if you choose this point, cutting plane will pass like this. Okay, so at the end you are going to get the same result. One of the extreme generators in the front view. Draw the development of the lateral surface of the truncated cylinder. That means if you pass a cutting plane and if you take away the top, whatever there above the cutting plane, so then the remaining portion is called as truncated cylinder. Okay, so this is the top view, front view, and the representation of the cutting plane. Okay, so step by step construction procedure you can see with the help of the video I am going to show. Okay, so are you able to see the screen now? Kanasta idya? So are you able to see the line? Likit? ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ವಾ? ಕುಶಾಲ್? ಸೊ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ಇಲ್ವಾ ಹೇಳಿ?
ಕೇಳಿಸಿದೆ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆರ್ ಯು ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದಿ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್? ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ?
ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಲೈನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ಎನಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ from projection of points to development of surfaces, you have to start from drawing XY line. Okay, then VP and HP. VP means vertical plane. So that means above this XY line is vertical plane, below this XY line is horizontal plane. On horizontal plane, so you can draw top view. On vertical plane, you can draw front view. Okay, that means top view will be projected on horizontal plane and front view will be projected on vertical plane. These are the fundamentals. I hope you know these things. Okay. So cylinder, in top view, it look like a circle. So that's why below the XY, a circle is drawn. It represents the top view of a cylinder. Okay, next you have to consider the dimension, that is 60 mm diameter. Okay, so draw a circle having diameter 60 mm. Okay, then for construction purpose, so you have to divide the circle into 8 or 12 equal parts. Okay, here I am dividing it into 8 equal parts. So just for construction, okay, so we are dividing the circle into 8 equal parts, similar to what you did in case of plane lamina, circular lamina, or in case of cylinder in projection of solids, or circular lamina in case of projection of planes. Okay, then after dividing the circle into 8 equal parts, so you have to name the points A, B, C, D like that. Okay, so here, so we have named it as A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and A1, B1, C1, D1, E1, F1, G1, H1. So here, so what does this A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H represent? It will represent which phase of the given solid, that is cylinder. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಡಿ ಇ ಎಫ್ ಜಿ ಎಚ್ ಯಾವುದನ್ನು ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ? ಎನಿ ಒನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಸೊ ಯಾರು ಬೇಕಾದರೂ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು, ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಆನ್ಸರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಡಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಡಿ ಇ ಎಫ್ ಜಿ ಎಚ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದಿ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸಿಲಿಂಡರ್. ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸಿಲಿಂಡರ್? ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಟಾಪ್, the end face which is nearer to observer will be visible. That means top end face is visible, that is represented by A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, then there is another end face, that is bottom end face, A1, B1, C1, D1, E1, F1, G1, H1. This is the bottom end face. If you look from top, this bottom end face is invisible. The invisible details are represented with the help of points inside the brackets. Okay, so next, after this you have to project the points. In order to draw the front view, you have to project all these division points. Okay, like this you have to project by drawing vertical lines. So then you know from in front view it look like a rectangle. So like this, so given height is 80 mm. Okay, after that, so you have to name the point. So again, so this is the front view. You are looking from here, front. Okay, so in front view, you are able to see only these points. A, B, C, D, E are visible, whereas F, G, H are invisible. Okay, in front view you are able to see only the front portion of the cylinder, so that means only half of the cylinder is visible from front. Okay, so that's why, so A1 dash, then B is visible, whereas this H is invisible. Okay, base is called as A1, B1, C1, D1, E1, F1, G1 and H1. Okay, so here A1 is visible, then B1 is visible, whereas H1, since it is on the back side, it is invisible. Next, C1 is visible and G1 is invisible. Next, here D1, this is nearer to the observer, this is the position of the observer. Okay, similarly here D1 is visible, F1 is invisible. Next, E1. Okay, similarly at the top end face you are having A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. In front view it is named as A dash, B dash, like that, with prime, or A prime, B prime. Here you can see. Okay, so this is the front view of the top end surface. Okay, so after drawing top view and front view of the cylinder, next you have to draw the cutting plane. Cutting plane is drawn with the help of a chain dashed line. Okay, this is the chain dashed line, so that is used to represent a cutting plane. And here, so they gave a condition. Okay, cutting plane will pass through one of the top end of the end generator. Okay, this is one end generator, this is another end generator. So it has to pass through, so top end of one of the end generator, that means either A or A dash or E dash or A prime or E prime, it has to pass through this. Then, so it has to pass through such that it is making an angle of 45 degree with axis. Okay, so this line should pass through this, and it has to make an inclination of 45 degree with this axis. Okay, so here axis is overlapping with other division points, that's why you cannot see it as a chain dash. Okay, but axis is on from here to here, this is the axis, and it is making an inclination of 45 degree. Okay, after passing the cutting plane, then you have to name the points where this cutting plane is cutting the vertical lines. Okay, you are naming it as 1, 2, like that, 3, 4, 5, like that you are naming it. Okay, so this is the cutting plane, and one, this is the point, okay, where cutting plane is passing through a vertical line A1 dash and A dash. Okay, 2 and 8, so these are the points where cutting plane is passing through the vertical construction line B1 prime and B prime, and also H1 prime and H dash. Okay, so H1 prime and H prime. Okay, so corresponding cutting point is represented by 8. So 3 here, in this case 3 is the cutting point for C1 dash and C dash. Okay, whereas 7 is the cutting point for G1 dash and G dash, similarly here and here also. Okay, so after that, so you have to, so represent the actual details of the cylinder with thick line. Okay, or here it should be with a thick curve, here it should be with a thick line. So actually, so these are the details of a cylinder. All remaining things are construction. These division lines, they are just construction lines. Okay, these two represent end generator of the cylinder. This represent base of the cylinder. This represent cylinder from in top view. Okay, and this represent the cutting plane. Remaining portion we are not representing with thick line. The reason is it will be removed, it will be cut, and it will be taken away. So that's why we are not representing remaining details. Okay, so that's why this vertical line here we are not representing it with thick line. The reason is this will be taken out. Okay, so this is the front and top view for the given condition. Next you have to develop, so that means you have to unfold it and you have to develop. Okay, in this you can see the development. If you want any clarification or if you have any doubts, you can ask. I will clear and your doubts. Okay, so if you have a doubt, if you want any clarification, you can ask. Feel free to ask doubts. Okay. Next, we are developing. So that means we are unfolding this truncated cylinder. Okay, as we discussed earlier, this width will be equal to pi d. D is the diameter of the cylinder. Okay. To consider 60 pi d, you are going to get 180.5. Okay, then we have to divide this horizontal line into 8 equal parts by using line division method. Okay, so this was already taught in the class itself, how to divide a line into a number of equal parts. Okay, so that line division method you have to make use of, and you must be able to divide this line into 8 equal parts. So in line division method, first you will draw a inclined line at any convenient angle. Then you are going to divide it into number of equal parts. Then you know the procedure. Okay, by using line division method, the horizontal line is divided into 8 equal parts. Okay, so you are naming the corresponding points on the bottom face of the cylinder. So when you unfold the bottom surface, it will look like a line, and you are naming that. So that is A1, B1. So in development, we are naming it by using uppercase letters, capital A, capital B, capital C. Okay. A1, B1, C1, D1, E1, F1, G1, H1. This will represent the bottom end face of the cylinder. Whereas A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, F, G represent top end face of the cylinder. Okay, you are unfolding it from A prime. Okay. Then, so after drawing a horizontal line for a length pi d, okay, then divide this horizontal line into 8 equal parts and then name it. So after that, draw vertical line to the height of the cylinder, that is 80 mm. Okay, then again complete this, then extend the division points by drawing vertical lines. Okay. So then you are able to get A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, A. Then, so you have to start drawing horizontal lines from all division points. So that means the points where the cutting plane is going to cut the vertical construction lines of the cylinder in front view. Okay, from these points, that is from 2, 8. So you have to draw a horizontal line. And again, this 2, 8, is cutting vertical line B1 dash and B dash. So here you have to draw this 2 to B1 and B till here. Then again there is another point 8. 8 is the cutting point of H1 dash and H dash. So again you have to extend this till H and H1. Okay. Similarly, next consider the next point, that is 3. 3 is for C1 dash and C, okay, from here to here. Then 7 is for G dash and G1, okay, next 4 and 6, so till F and F, so 5, so till E and E, okay, like that. So you have to drop horizontal lines which are parallel to one another to the corresponding vertical lines in the developed segment of the construction. Okay. Next, you have to number these points. Okay, after getting these points, so next you have to make this bold. So that means the actual development. Okay, so after making this as thick lines, then you have to connect by freehand. Okay, you have to draw a arc from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8, and 8 to 1. This should be drawn with freehand. Okay, here you cannot connect these points with the help of a scale. You cannot do that. For cylinder and cone, you have to connect these points by freehand such that you are going to get a smooth curve like this. Okay, this is the development. And we are not representing these vertical lines as thick lines. The reason is they are just construction lines. In cylinder, it is not possible for you to visualize the lateral edges. Okay, for that reason, these are just construction lines. We are representing only the end generator. That is these two lines. Okay, so this is the solution for this for the given problem. Okay, where there is a cylinder which is kept in vertical orientation. It is having a diameter of 60 mm and height of 80 mm. And there is a cutting plane which is perpendicular to VP. And making an inclination of 45 degree with axis of the cylinder, and it is passing through one of the top end points of the end generator. So that means this point or this, you can consider either this or this. Okay, then so draw the cutting plane. So then we are going to develop only the truncated cylinder, that means only the portion below this cutting plane. Okay, so then consider a point for unfolding. Here we are considering A1 for unfolding, this one. Okay. So then from where you start, so there it will end. So if you start from A1, it has to end with A1. Okay. When you join, this will become a single edge. When you unfold, a single edge will be divided into two edges. That's why you are having A1 twice. The reason is, again, if you fold it and if you bring them back, it will be joined and it will become a single edge, okay, or single line. When you unfold, it will be divided into two lines. Okay, so that's why you are having A1 twice. Okay.